Welcome. You're all excited. All right. Very good. If you have your Bibles, open up to 2 Kings. I'm going to read you a story. And then what we want to do tonight is we want to break up and we want to pray. We want to break into small groups and we want to pray. We usually pray on the first Wednesday of the month, and we usually meet at 6 o'clock in the morning, and there's usually 3 to 10 of us here. But we start out usually with 2 or 3 of us. And so today I just decided we were going to do that tonight. We don't have Awana tonight. It's really quiet here. Our children are on spring break at the school, so it's going to be a little bit of a different service. But I'm going to start before I read the text about Elisha, about one of my favorite Clint Eastwood movies. It's called The Outlaw Josie Wales. Anybody ever see The Outlaw Josie Wales? Okay. I'm going to try and be politically correct here. There's a Native American in the movie, and he tries to sneak up on Clint Eastwood. Doesn't work. Clint sneaks up on him usually, or somebody's always sneaking up on this guy. But he says, "I'm looking for an edge." He's always looking for an edge. And through the whole movie, he tells people Clint Eastwood has an edge. The sun will be at his back. He'll do this. He'll do that. And he has an edge. And I want to read you a story, and tonight when we pray, I want you to think about having an edge in this life, having an advantage in this life, okay? 2 Kings chapter 6, beginning in verse 8. Now the king of Aram was at war. Man, I can hardly see. I'm going to have to get my glasses one of these days. Was at war with Israel. After conferring with his officers, he said, "I will set up my camp in such and such a place." The man of God sent word, that's Elisha, to the king of Israel, "Beware of passing that place because the Arameans are going down there." So the king of Israel checked on the place indicated by the man of God. Time and again, Elisha warned the king so that he was on his guard in such places. Now this enraged the king of Aram. He summoned his officers and demanded of them, "Will you not tell me which of us is on the side of the king of Israel?" He thought there was a spy in the camp. "None of us, my lord," the king said of his one of his officers, "but Elisha, the prophet who is in Israel, tells the king of Israel the very words you speak in your bedroom." Isn't that awesome? "Go find out where he is," the king ordered, "so I can send men and capture him." The report came back, "He's in Dothan." And then he sent horses and chariots and a strong force there. And they went by night, and they surrounded the city. And when the servant of the man of God got up and went out early the next morning, an army with horses and chariots had surrounded the city. "Oh, my lord, what shall we do?" the servant asked. "Don't be afraid," the prophet answered. "Those who are with us are more than those who are with them." And Elisha prayed, "Oh, Lord, open his eyes so he may see." And then the Lord opened the servant's eyes, and he looked and saw the hills full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. As the enemy came down toward him, Elisha prayed to the Lord, "Strike these people with blindness." So he struck them with blindness as Elisha had asked. And Elisha told them, "This is not the road, and this is not the city. Follow me, and I will lead you to the man you are looking for." And he led them to Samaria. After they entered the city, Elisha said, "Lord, open the eyes of these men so they can see." Then the Lord opened the eyes, and they looked, and there they were inside Samaria. Now when the king of Israel saw them, he asked Elisha, "Shall I kill them, my father? Shall I kill them?" "Do not kill them," he answered. "Would you kill men you have captured with your own sword or bow? Set food and water before them so that they may eat and drink and then go back to their master." So he prepared a great feast for them, and after they had finished eating and drinking, he sent them away, and they returned to their master. So the bands from Aram stopped raiding Israel's territory. Now my question for you is, do you seek God every day for everything going on in your life? Now, granted, we don't all have miracles happening like Elisha, but it appears to me Elisha was always several steps ahead of the enemy because he was always talking to God. And then it says he prayed and they were blinded. He prayed and his servant's eyes were opened, and then he prayed and the eyes of the enemy were closed, and then he led them into the city and captured them in a sense, and then he prayed and their eyes were opened. Then the awesome thing is he let them all go. Well, my question for us tonight, as we prepare to pray, do you wake up in the morning and talk to God? Do you ask God for help on a daily basis, on a incident-by-incident basis? Do you say, God, what should we do? What should we do? You see, I know Elisha was an anointed prophet of God, and he had a lot of miracles done with him, but I don't think our God has changed. Okay, I don't think he's changed. And tonight we're going to break up and pray. Now, before we do that, God's just reminded me of a story. I've told it 100 times. If you're in this church, you've heard it, but you're going to hear it again. And it's about asking God and asking him for things. It was like 20 below zero one day, and I couldn't get my John Deere tractor started. And I don't know if you know this, but cows in a barn, there's a certain substance behind the cows that keeps piling up. And our barn was full of it. And we worked all morning, and we worked half the afternoon, and we couldn't get that tractor to start. And the manure was piling up, and we had to clean the barn, and we didn't know what else to do. And we had tried everything we knew humanly to do. And I finally went out, and the last thing I did was I got in the cab of the tractor, and I said out loud with my brother and my brother-in-law listening, I said, Father, in the name of Jesus, please start this tractor. First time I had said that in a whole day. I don't know what was wrong with me. I was just dense. And that tractor started like it was 100 degrees outside. And what I heard from my brother and my brother-in-law was, why didn't you say that at 8 o'clock this morning? That's a great question, isn't it? And so what we're going to do now is I want to break into small groups, all right? We're just going to have to do that. We're big people, so we can do it. But let's break up into small groups, and I want to remind you, pray about the things going on in your life. Please don't forget to pray for our nation, okay? Pray for our nation that God will call us back to himself and that there would be revival here in Walworth County. But then pray for the things you need. If there's any here that are sick, have the people in your group just lay hands on you and pray. Because I believe God wants to work, and I believe this may be the best Wednesday night we have. Okay, so let's just break up now. We'll pray. When your small group is done praying, you're free to go, or you can stay and fellowship, okay? But that's what we're going to do now. So let's break up, and I'm going to join a group somewhere here. So let's go. Let's get to it.